Hello everyone, medical scribe. I'm Karar Haidar, student at Baghdad Medical College. Today we will talk about the skin appendages and the hair structure from an anatomical point of view. The skin appendages are structures exist in the skin, which are derived from the epidermal and the dermal layers. The skin appendages include many structures: the hair, the sebaceous glands, the sweaty glands, and the nails. And for every element, there is a specific structure, and specific functions, and specific histology. And today, we will talk about the hair structure, which is the first element in these appendages. The hair is one of the characteristics of the human body, which have many features and many functions that we will explain them in the upcoming videos. Structurally, every hair consists of two major parts, which are the hair shaft and the hair follicle. And we will talk about each one of them and understand all their details. Firstly, we have the hair shaft. The hair shaft is the visible portion of the hair, which is above the skin level. So what we see with our eyes is the hair shaft only. This shaft contains a protein called keratin, which is a very strong protein that resists the tear and wear forces. And if we need to talk about the structures of the hair shaft, it will composed of three layers: the cuticle layer, the cortical layer or the cortex, and the central medulla. So regarding the cuticle layer, it is the outermost layer of the hair shaft that protects the hair and surround the cortex. The cortex is the layer that found under the cuticle layer, which will represent the main bulk of the hair, and the color of the hair that we see will exist in this layer. While the central medulla will exist only in the thick hair, and it's of course the innermost layer in the hair shaft, and it contains the transparent cells. So this is regarding the hair shaft structure, which is the first major part of the hair. While the hair follicle, which is the second major part, it will composed also from three main regions, which are the infundibulum, the isthmus, and the inferior segment or the suprabulbar region. So regarding the infundibulum, it is the region that extends from the epidermal invagination, or the point where the hair enters the epidermis, till the level of the sebaceous gland duct opening. This region called the infundibulum. The second region is the isthmus. This isthmus will extend from the sebaceous gland duct opening, or from the end of the infundibulum we can say, till the point of the arrector pili muscle insertion. And in this region we found the bulge area. It's thought that in this bulge area the stem cells of the hair will reside. So this is regarding the second region, which is the isthmus. While the third region is the inferior segment or the suprabulbar region of the follicle. This region considered as the growing portion of the follicle, that at its base will expand to form the bulb of the follicle. This bulb is concave in shape and function to promote the growth of the hair follicle, because we will find here a group of cells called the matrix cells, which make the hair to grow longer. These matrix cells composed mainly of two types of cells, which are the keratinocytes and the melanocytes. The keratinocytes are the cells that proliferate to form the hair shaft, while the melanocytes are the cells that make pigment called melanin, which give the hair its color. So this is regarding the contents of the matrix cells that found in the bulb, which found in the inferior segment of the hair follicle. And not to miss that the bulb in general will be contained by a vascular loose connective tissue called the dermal papilla. And because the dermal papilla has vessels and nerves, so it will nourish the cells in the bulb in order to make them grow in the normal way. So this is the structural form of the inferior segment with all its details, which will make with the other two regions, the isthmus and the infundibulum, making the hair follicle structure. Lastly, near the hair follicle, we have an involuntary smooth muscle and a sebaceous gland. This is smooth muscle called the arrector pili muscle, which connects between the hair follicle and the superficial part of the dermis layer. This muscle will be innervated by a sympathetic nerve fiber, so it will contract and relax automatically and involuntarily in special situations. So when it contracts, it will pull the hair to a more vertical direction and causes it to erect, making the goosebump phenomenon or dimpling of the skin surface. So sometimes when we feel a cold or face a scary situation, our skin will dimple and the hair erect. This is a process done by these muscles. And in the same time, when this muscle contracts, it will squeeze the sebaceous gland that may position between the hair and the muscle. So the gland will be squeezed by the muscle contraction. As a result, it will secrete some of its oil secretion on the skin surface. And this secretion also have many functions, talking about them later. So that was almost everything about the hair structure. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.